This morning we celebrate the Mass of the 29th Sunday in Ordinary Time. This Holy Mass is offered for the repose of the soul of David Thomas, whose anniversary occurs around now. Naturally, we also remember Sir David Amess to pray for his eternal repose, also remembering his wife Julia, his children, and all his family and friends at this tragic time. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and prepare ourselves for these sacred mysteries. I confess. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. For seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, grant that we may always conform our will to yours and to serve your majesty in sincerity of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. The Lord has been pleased to crush his servant with suffering if he offers his life in atonement. He shall see his heirs, he shall have a long life, and through him what the Lord wishes will be done. His soul's anguish over, He shall see the light and be content. By his sufferings shall my servant justify many, taking their faults on himself. The word of the Lord. A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Since in Jesus, the Son of God, we have the supreme high priest who has gone through to the highest heaven, we must never let go of the faith that we have professed. For it is not as if we had a high priest who was incapable of feeling our weakness with us, but we have one who has been tempted in every way that we are, though he is without sin. Let us be confident then in approaching the throne of grace, that we shall have mercy from him and find grace when we are in need of his help. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. James and John, the sons of Zebedee, approached Jesus. Master, they said to him, we want you to do us a favor. He said to them, what is it you want me to do for you? They said to him, allow us to sit, one at your right hand and the other at your left, in your glory. You do not know what you are asking, Jesus said to them. Can you drink the cup that I must drink, or be baptized with the baptism with which I must be baptized? They replied, we can. Jesus said to them, the cup that I must drink, you shall drink, and with the baptism with which I must be baptized, you shall be baptized. But as for seats at my right hand or my left, these are not mine to grant, They belong to those to whom they have been allotted. When the other 10 heard this, they began to feel indignant with James and John. So Jesus called them to him and said to them, "You know that among the pagans, their so-called rulers lord it over them, and their great men make their authority felt. This is not to happen among you. No, anyone who wants to become great among you must be your servant, and anyone who wants to be first among you must be slave to all. For the Son of Man himself did not come to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as a ransom for many." The Gospel of the Lord. The tragic events of Friday are very much on our minds, I'm sure, today. And our hearts and prayers go out massively to the wife and the family of Sir David Amess, a Member of Parliament. And no doubt, many people will be asking many different questions at this time. People from all kinds of backgrounds and faiths about how such evil can happen, why it happens, and even why God would allow such to happen. Of course, it does remind us all to be very vigilant at all times and in all places, and also to pray for the perpetrators of crime and evil acts, to pray for mercy and for reconciliation, which are at the very heart of our religion. Such acts of violence and terror, of course, are symptoms of a human race gone wrong. It's what we Catholics, what we Christians know as original sin. And we see it here writ large. Original sin, writ large. Now, we all possess pride, often in bucket loads. And it's our pride that will allow us or prevent us from undertaking certain behaviours. When the ego wants to grasp power for itself, things get dangerous and dysfunctional very quickly. And if we want our own way all of the time, then we will go to any lengths to get it. The Gospel of this Sunday presents us with two of the closest friends of Jesus, his two closest apostles, really, James and John, who are hungry for honor and power. Two of the classic vices that can turn someone criminal in order to get what they want at any cost. Now, let's be fair. Power isn't a bad thing. Power is the capacity to get things done. Without power, nothing of value would have been accomplished. Think of some of our great rulers, from St. Edward the Confessor, whom we celebrated this week, down to Winston Churchill and everyone else in between. They had to get hold of the reins of power in order to bring us through, and to bring our land through, difficult and decisive moments. This is also true, of course, of great inventors and great explorers, and of course of the great spiritual figures in our Christian history. On the parish social media this weekend, you'll see I've put there a picture of Sir David with Mother Teresa, Saint Mother Teresa. Now, don't think for a moment that Saint Mother Teresa didn't have real power and didn't know how to use it. Anyone who knew her saw a very powerful woman indeed. The other picture I've put on the parish social media this weekend is of Sir David with Pope John Paul, Saint Pope John Paul. One of the most remarkable displays of real spiritual power in our time was that of Saint Pope John Paul II, who knew precisely what he was doing when he brought down one of the most powerful empires in human history, communism, atheistic communism. And he did that without leading an army, or without firing a bullet, or without wielding a knife. He had a very canny sense of his own power and of how to use it. So power in itself is not a bad thing. The same is true of honour. Honour is a good thing. St. Thomas Aquinas says that honour is the flag of virtue. I think that's quite a cool definition. Honour is the flag of virtue. And it's the flag that we put on virtue so that we can behave well and we can say, look at this. Look at something good. So we honour somebody who is upright, a statesman. We give them knighthoods. And we're saying, look, here is a virtue. Here is a good, and let's honour it. The thing about honour is that it's not for our own sake, not for the sake of the one honoured. It's for the sake of others who might notice that virtue in question. So we honour all kinds of people who embody things that are worthy of note. And in the church, of course, we like honour a lot because we honour the saints, and above all, we honour our Blessed Lady. So what's the problem with asking for power and honour? What did James and John get wrong? Well, they're asking for these two goods in the wrong way, or in the wrong spirit. When the ego grabs power and honour for itself, things get dangerous and dysfunctional very quickly. Just look at some of the politicians that we've got in our land and we've had in history. Look what motivates them, what moves them to power and honour. And look at how often that goes wrong. Unless they're prepared to use power and honour for the sake of the nation and for the good of other people, and where they don't, their ego just gets inflated. Because our ego always wants to use power and position, not for God's purpose or in the service of others. Our ego wants to use power for its own exaltation and defence. And up and down the centuries, when spiritually immature people have come into power, be it politics or in the arts or in the church, they create havoc in short order. Someone who is spiritually and humanly immature very quickly becomes manipulative, cruel, oppressive, overbearing. And history gives us countless examples of this, from Julius Caesar and Herod to Napoleon, Hitler and Stalin and the rest. When power gets twisted, when it gets skewed, the more dangerous it becomes, as we have seen. And also when honour is sought for its own sake, it becomes very dangerous too. Because people will do anything for recognition. They'll put themselves out there in the front line and lie, manipulate, even kill, in extreme cases, to get the honour and the recognition that they crave. Now, if this all sounds a bit pessimistic as a view of human nature, there is the antidote, of course. The antidote is freedom. To free oneself of all of that, as the saints did, because the saints were the freest people ever. The way out is to do what Jesus says. The way out is to do the opposite. This is the spirituality of saints like Ignatius of Loyola. So Ignatius of Loyola taught the agere contra, to act against. So if you're hung up on power and honour, the best thing to do is to seek the opposite. To seek the lowest place, to seek the place of least recognition, and to do so on purpose. Without the grace of God, we all have the ability to go wrong, to follow our own desires, to seek honour and power in itself for ourselves. With the grace of God, we can orient our lives towards the good, towards God. And so, quite simply, the simplest thing we can do is to place all of this into the hands of our loving Father God, who knows it all. And of course, as always, and in this month of October, to go to the Mother. Because as all mothers know, when they're fulfilling their role perfectly, they can draw in all of the members of the family, support, sustain, and console them with that unselfish love and with that complete desire, in the case of Our Lady, to unite everyone in her Son, Jesus Christ. Praise be Jesus Christ, now and forever. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things are made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. God is our refuge and strength. In confidence now, we ask for his help.
For prisoners, their families, and all who work within the penal system, may the Lord bring them strength in adversity, hope in his promises, and true conversion of heart.
Lord, hear us.
For our MP, Sir David Amis, and his family, may God grant him eternal repose and his family peace and hope.
Lord, hear us.
We pray for Pope Francis as he prepares the church for the next synod, that he may lead Christ's faithful in truth, faith, and unity.
Lord, hear us.
We pray for those who have died recently and for the dead whose anniversaries occur about this time. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful live in peace. May Mary, Queen of the Apostles and Mother of the Church, intercede for us as we say, Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, hail to our life of sweetness and honor. in the quiet of our hearts. Let us bring any special needs before our loving Father.
Almighty Father, hear our prayers and guide us and your church in the ways of tranquility and peace. We make these prayers through Christ our Lord. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Grant us, Lord, we pray, a sincere respect for your gifts, that through the purifying action of your grace, we may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of us mortal beings with your own divinity. and even fashion for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation in Christ. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord,
and profess your resurrection.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May you make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Alan, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you've summoned before you, In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen."
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Show each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that benefiting from participation in heavenly things, we may be helped by what you give us in this present age and prepared for the gifts that are eternal. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
You might like to read the pastoral message from our bishop on the parish website, in which he sets out his own sentiments following the death of Sir David Amess. And we will, of course, shortly announce a date for a memorial mass here at a time when things are more tranquil and we can gather together those members of our community who have been affected by this death in a dignified and orderly way. So I'll announce a date for that in the near future. In the meantime, I wish you all a very blessed week ahead. God keep you safe and be vigilant.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.